Hi, my name is Taylor Reif, and I'll be discussing benign bone tumor management with you today. Let's start with some definitions. A tumor is an abnormal growth of neoplastic cells. Now, neoplastic means new, so new cells that have changes in their underlying DNA, which leads to their growth and multiplication into a mass known as a tumor. Now, benign tumors are not cancerous, meaning they do not spread to other tissues, and this usually means they are not life-threatening. Benign, however, can still be aggressive and require treatment. Here we have a 23-year-old male who was undergoing limb lengthening of his left femur, which was progressing well. The bone was distracting, and he was forming new bone in the distraction gap. But note how odd the bone looks in the tibia, which was not undergoing the distraction. There's this area that's clearly defined and looks more what we call radiolucent than the surrounding bone. Advanced imaging is then obtained in the form of CT or an MRI to better delineate the mass. Here you can see that the mass extends just up to the surface of the knee joint and the tibia, along the medial cortex, as well as along the anterior cortex, which has a small fracture in it, likely from lack of stability since the tumor has replaced the underlying bone structure. The treatment of these tumors is an aggressive curettage, which means scraping away all the abnormal tumor. Here you can see that curette is being used along all the surfaces of the tumor cavity to remove all that abnormal tissue. An argon beam coagulator is then used, which produces extreme heat and further desiccates the bone to make sure all the tumor cells are destroyed along the edges of this tumor. The void is then packed with a synthetic bone cement, which provides initial structural stability to the cavity until the bone itself is able to heal. This was the first visit after surgery for the patient, and you can see the bone is filled with that absorbable cement, which initially is much denser than the surrounding bone. And here you can see how the healing of that bone cavity takes place over the following year. The healthy bone begins to invade the bone cement, replacing it with normal bone matrix. And subsequent X-rays show the bone cement gets smaller and smaller until it's replaced entirely by normal, healthy bone. Here's another case example to illustrate the point. This is a 25-year-old female who presents with mild pain in the knee. X-rays were obtained, which shows this clear abnormality in the medial tibia. Advanced imaging in the form of an MRI is then obtained, which also shows the extent of the tumor within the tibia, gives you some indication of the tumor matrix, and helps plan the resection of this tumor. Again, surgery begins with an aggressive curettage of the entire tumor, followed by the argon beam coagulator. The tibia is again filled with a synthetic bone cement, and our pathologists examine the tumor specimen and are able to identify this as a periosteal chondroma, which is a form of cartilage tumor. Following this patient, you can see the radiodense bone cement is resorbed as the normal healthy bone grows back into that void. And on progressive X-rays, shot months apart, that bone cement is nearly completely absorbed and normal bone matrix replaces it. Thank you for listening. You can find more of my content on Instagram and Facebook.